creator friends, this is Kathy from Easy Sunday Club. On our YouTube channel, we make videos on practical business strategies, how-tos, and occasionally watercolor tutorials. I've been getting a lot of questions about shipping lately, what you should use to ship certain products, how much they cost, etc. So I just want to simplify a little bit for you. I will share with you some pro tips I've learned about shipping efficiently and economically over the years, and I'll also show you what I use to ship each of my product types and how much they cost in ballpark. Obviously, I'm based in the US, so a lot of these shipping methods and rates will apply to US only. I'm not familiar with shipping methods and rates outside of US. So sorry, I can't help you there. If you're not US-based, you might be able to learn something about how I package my products. And another thing is, this is for my art business. What I sell tend to be these flat items like cards and art prints, or the bulkiest item I have is this baby blanket. So I have a wide range of shipping packaging methods for you. There are three factors I think affect the shipping costs. One is the dimension of the package, second is total weight, and third is the destination. So hopefully I'll cover a wide range of those here. And there are three pro tips that I wanna first share with you. First, if you're just starting to ship physical products and you don't have a system set up at home, please, please, please don't go to the post office to ship your orders. If you're on Etsy, you can print out labels directly from Etsy and from online. And if you're on Shopify, they have that as well. There are also third-party shipping platforms. Let's say if you don't have a website yet and someone orders from you directly, and you want to ship that product, instead of going to the post office, you can use those third-party shipping platforms. I use GoShippo, which syncs with both Shopify and Etsy orders, so it's easy to manage there. You can also use other like ShipStation, Shipping Easy. There's a handful of them out there. I did a little bit of rates comparison. I would say that if your volume isn't that high, there's not going to be a huge difference in rates between these services, and they all charge people differently, sometimes by order, pay as you go, or other times you have to pay a monthly fee. So if you're only on Etsy in the beginning, just stay with Etsy. I think Etsy rates are pretty favorable, to be honest. The second pro tip I want to share is, when you're shipping products, try to keep the weight under 1 pound. And this applies specifically to USPS, because anything that's over 1 pound, the total weight of the package, if it's over 1 pound, then you automatically have to upgrade to USPS priority. Of course, you can ship in UPS too. With USPS, if you're shipping something that's under a pound, like if this is only 2 ounces or a larger print is 12 ounces, you can use first class package, which costs anywhere between $3 to $5 with tracking to ship within the United States. Once you go up to above 1 pound, then you have to use USPS priority. And even though it ships to the destination quicker, it's gonna cost you more money. It ranges from like $7 all the way to $14. So I'm based in California. If I have to ship priority to like say Connecticut or New Jersey, it's gonna cost me up to $11 to $14, which is quite a lot. And I don't pass the entire cost to the customer, because to be honest, like nowadays, who wants to pay $14 to buy something that weighs like 2 pounds, unless it's super valuable or something. That's my 2 cents about that. And the third one is, start buying your packaging material in bulk, maybe before you're ready, especially if you're selling flat items like these greeting cards or art prints. The packaging material for them, you know, I like these rigid mailers. They don't take up a lot of space if you buy them in 25s or packs of 50. I think I get them from Uline or Paper Mart. I'll link everything below. Because when you buy them individually, they're gonna cost so much more. Like, I don't even know what the price difference is if you buy something like this from the post office, but they're gonna charge you because you're paying for the convenience. And then lastly, I know USPS offers these flat rate boxes. You pick them up for free there. So you're thinking like, oh, I'm saving money there and it's flat rate. In my experience, those flat rate boxes are ideal if you're shipping something that are small and heavy, because you get to take advantage of the flat rate. If you're just shipping something light, the flat rate is not gonna bring you savings. You're better off just finding a box or, you know, something flat like this to fit what you're trying to ship. And I don't ship anything small and heavy, or someone buys like 6 mugs from you, maybe you can somehow manage to fit tightly into one of those flat rate boxes. Otherwise, I just haven't found it to be super useful for what I'm shipping. Now, all right, let's move on to what I use to shipping different products. For greeting cards, I have been using these rigid mailers to ship greeting cards since the beginning. Whether they buy 1 card or 5 cards, I think you can fit 5 to 6 cards in one of these. And I always use USPS first class package with tracking. That's going to cost more, obviously. Single card weighs about 3 ounces in here, maybe 2. And 5 cards is gonna weigh like 5 ounce-ish. I think between 2 to 5 ounce, the cost is about the same, which is in the $3 to $5 range if you use USPS first class package with tracking. If you don't want to use tracking, it costs around $120, $150 to just put a postage on it. Of course, you can put stamps on it if you want to just mail this inside a larger envelope, but I just don't trust that because the envelope is flimsy already and it might get bent. It's not like you're sending a birthday card to your mom or something, right? Like you're sending it to a customer and they want it in pristine condition. So I always use this to ship. Another question that comes to me often is, like, can you just ship without tracking? Like, can you just ship cards in the cheapest ways possible? And yes, I know plenty of shops do it. If they sell mostly greeting cards, they'll just offer free shipping and put stamps on them or put label on them. And that's totally fine. I'm just not fully comfortable with it. Recently, I did start offering the cheaper shipping method for a single card. It's like the $1, $150 range. But if they buy more than one card, if they spend like more than $10, I always force them to pay for shipping. Maybe I've lost some sales when I have multiple orders going out. Sometimes you're gonna get these customer service emails asking like, where's my order? Why is my order not here yet? Granted, even with tracking, people still ask you that. When there's no tracking, you have no idea where it is. To me, it's a risk I'm willing to take with a lower price item like a single card, because if it is lost and I have no idea where it is without tracking, I'll just send them a replacement. It's $5, cost me less to make it, and that's a risk I'm willing to bear. If it's something larger in value, I just don't want to risk it, and I'm doing it for peace of mind. And I pass that cost, not entirely, I subsidize that cost to the customer. If you buy a single card from me on my website, you pay $250 for a single card with tracking or $120 without tracking. In actuality, it's going to cost me over $3 to ship it to you with tracking. That's where like it's important to know what your profit margin is, because if you can't afford to subsidize shipping at all for the customer, then you want to charge them exactly how much it costs to ship it. But I would say, you know, have a healthy margin so that you can play with different shipping costs, because shipping fee can be prohibitive to people who want to make purchase thanks to Amazon, who have trained everyone to think that everything should be shipped for free and arrive at our doorstep in the next day. That's my 2 cents about greeting card. If someone does purchase a bulk order greeting card, like for wholesale orders, obviously I wouldn't use this. I would use a box for those, and most likely I'll be shipping with USPS priority. The second product category I ship is greeting cards. These are 8x10s, and this is 11x14. So the largest rigid mailer I use for my print is a 12x15, which fit this larger print, and have a small mailer for this. If they buy single print, and that's gonna cost like $1.50 to $2.50 less. Again, I never use shipping method without tracking for my prints, so I don't ever use that. Etsy doesn't even give you that option. So if you're on Shopify, you probably see that shipping method showing up. And let me know, by the way, if you are shipping without tracking and you haven't had any issues. Maybe I'm just being paranoid. So far, I just know I want to reduce customer service time as much as possible, at least from people that want to know where their order is. So I feel like I'm paying that premium for that peace of mind and that time reduction. I do sell prints larger than 11x14. My largest print is 16x20. And for those, I packaged them in this mailing tube. Surprisingly, this mailing tube is really light. So even though the print's bigger, for a single print, it weighs less than this rigid mailer here. So I end up spending about the same to ship a large print in a mailing tube. For as to how much I charge the customer, it's anywhere between $2 to $5, depending on what the value of the cart is. Obviously, if they buy more prints from me, then they'll pay a little more. I do like shipping with these mailing tubes. I feel like it's the most secure. Sometimes when I ship with this rigid mailer at this size, 12 by 15 inch, once in a while I get feedback from customers that their edges are bent just because it's rigid, but you know, if these get thrown at the wall or something, or they're stacked underneath something that's oddly shaped, then things could get damaged. Sometimes if I ship a print this size to somewhere far on the other side of the country, then I'll place two backboards on each side for extra reinforcement. And that still keeps the weight under 1 pound. Remember, I'm optimizing for under 1 pound as much as I can. These are all the prints. I do have pins on my Etsy shop still. And for that, I use this bubble envelope. I don't really sell pins that much anymore. Whatever I have left on my Etsy shop, I'm selling through them and then I'll discontinue. But pins are going to cost as much as art to ship. So it's about like 1 to 2 ounces for a single pin. That's it for my flat items. Now I'll talk about bulk items. This is going to fit my baby blanket perfectly. Here. And this whole thing weighs 2.5 pounds. For weight over 1 pound, you want to do some price comparison. If you're on Shopify, I'm going to give you rates from UPS and USPS. So sometimes UPS ground is cheaper for shipping something heavier, or if you're shipping to across the country. If you're shipping like within the same region, like in the same state or in a neighboring state or on the same coast where you're at in the US, then a USPS might be cheaper. So I would encourage you to do some price comparison. But this box will work for both USPS and UPS, unless you're shipping something like huge bulk or you have a commercial account with them, which requires super high volume. So I'm just comparing USPS and UPS here. I also have larger boxes. My wholesale orders, I have boxes even larger than this. If a store is buying 5 of my blankets, I have a couple of boxes in this size and something a little flatter. I like to err on the side of ordering slightly larger, taller boxes than I need, because sometimes I would cut down the top to collapse it to reduce the height. But the box is too small, you can't create extra space. And then I know about wholesale too. We have a video about how we package our bulk item packages. So, and that's gonna be right here. It's mostly for wholesale orders. I won't go into detail here. And obviously wholesale order is going to be over 1 pound. And most of the time the cost is passed to the retailer. If I have good relationship with them or someone is a repeat buyer, sometimes I'll offer a flat rate or I'll subsidize it for them if their order is large. But that's a side note if you start doing wholesale. Okay, so lastly, let's talk about international shipping. International shipping is a pain in the peach. Every time I get an international order, I have this mixed feeling between gratitude that someone from, you know, South Africa wants to buy one of my paintings, or like someone from Japan wants to buy my blanket, to that it's not going to get there on time, or it's going to take 6 weeks, or it might get lost and I might have to send a replacement. It's going to cost me $50. So I always go through that. Canada orders to me is not as nerve-wracking. Unfortunately, for all of my international orders, unless the customer didn't tell me anything, I've never had a package that was lost. I've had plenty of customers email me about where is their order, even though there's tracking, because it just takes a long time to ship international shipments. You would think that we have airplanes now, that it should take maybe a couple of weeks to get to the other side of the world, but no, it doesn't. Lately, I've had an order to Sweden that took 6 weeks to arrive, went to Germany that took 5. And then one tip about shipping international too is I would not use UPS, because at least for my Canada order, charge recipient for duty. When you're comparing the rates on your end, it looks like UPS is cheaper, but when it gets there, they're going to charge the customer the customs fee. I got a complaint about that once, and then since then I've stopped using UPS for that reason. USPS International is not the greatest. They do take their time to get to the international destination, but unfortunately, we don't have a lot of choices. I know DHL is the best. Like, if I want to get something quick to another country, then DHL is my go-to. And I mean, it's going to cost an arm and leg, but for most things that you're selling, it's not cost-effective to use DHL. But if anyone knows a better international service, let me know. I just feel like, at least in the US, it's so expensive for us small businesses to ship internationally because we don't have the volume to purchase something in bulk, like a container or something to ship international. So, and then in terms of cost for international, the range widely varies. I shipped as far as Australia is one of the furthest places I've shipped, and that costs like $30 to $40 to ship something that weighs like 4 pounds, which is crazy because the customer didn't pay that much. I didn't charge that much to ship there. I kind of had to swallow the cost when I found out how much it was. It like really hurt my margins. For that order, I might have broken even or something, and I just had to go back and edit my shipping rates for Australia. And there's other countries like that too. I guess that I'm super grateful that people from other countries shop from my online store. Like, I rarely shop from online stores from another country unless I really, really like something. So it is flattering, and to me, I don't mind subsidizing shipping more to have something in another country. Some sellers don't like that. They don't want the hassle. They don't want to deal with lost packages and replacement costs. But like I said, most of my packages eventually get there. You just have to reassure the customer. Usually that's what I tell them, and I try to tell them to give it another week or two, and if it doesn't arrive, I will refund their money. And I've never had to refund anyone's money because you show them patience and kindness and try to see where they're coming from. And yeah, I haven't had many horror stories, if at all, from customers, at least. Hopefully that's reassuring about shipping internationally. So that's everything I can think of to share about shipping. And if you have new insights about how you ship, that's maybe even better than how I ship, please let me know. I'm not a shipping guru here. Leave your feedback below. I'll read all of them. Thanks for watching. If you're just starting out, remember, you don't have to have everything figured out. You just have to take the next step. And for shipping, you also don't have to have everything figured out. And maybe after this video, you will have a little more clarity on what to do. Good luck, and I'll see you next time.